Hello everyone. Today in this video I will be talking about a CPU scheduling algorithm. Now before moving on to the algorithm, you should know some definitions. Okay, the first one is burst time. Now burst time is the duration for which a process gets control over the CPU. Okay, then we have preemptive scheduling. Okay, now preemptive scheduling means a running task can be interrupted to execute a task having more priority, and then the leftover task which was interrupted, that can be resumed later. Okay, and then we have non-preemptive scheduling, where the running task can't be interrupted in any way and it can't be interrupted until it has completed its execution. Okay, so the difference between preemptive and non-preemptive is that in preemptive scheduling the running task can be interrupted to execute a task having more priority, but in non-preemptive any running task can't be interrupted in any way until it has completed its execution. Okay, then we have quantum. Quantum is a time slice or a duration of time which is allotted to each process. Okay, a fixed duration allotted to each process. Now let's start with the first CPU scheduling algorithm, that is FCFS. Now FCFS means first come first serve. Okay, so as the name suggests, the process which will arrive early will be executed before the other processes. Okay, now this algorithm follows the non-preemptive approach. Okay, that is the running tasks can't be interrupted until they have finished their execution. So let's see the numerical. Now the numerical can be like this: calculate average waiting time. Okay, so you will be asked to calculate the average waiting time for each of the CPU scheduling algorithms. Okay, so let's see the numerical for FCFS. Now a table will be given which will contain process and burst time, and burst time is in milliseconds. Okay, so the process, there are 5 processes: P1, P2, P3, P4 and P5. Their burst time respectively are 10, 1, 2, 1 and 5. Okay, now in order to calculate the average waiting time, we need to draw a graphical representation of this process and their burst time. Okay, and that graphical representation is known as the Gantt chart. Okay, so the graphical representation is known as the Gantt chart. From this Gantt chart, we will be able to calculate the waiting times for each of the processes. Okay, and from that we will finally calculate the average waiting time. Now let's see how we will calculate the waiting times from the Gantt chart. Now, since arrival time of these processes have not been mentioned, therefore we will consider they all arrive at 0 millisecond. Okay, so all the processes arrive at 0 millisecond to the CPU, or rather the the processes form the ready queue at 0 millisecond, and from the ready queue the processes will be allowed to take control over the CPU. Okay, so this will start from 0 millisecond and we will start from the first. Okay, since there is no priorities mentioned, therefore we will start from the first, as the name of the algorithm is first come first serve. So P1 is first, so it will be allowed first. So P1 is taking 10 milliseconds to complete its execution, so it ends at 10. Then comes P2 completes its execution in 1 millisecond, so that means this will be 10 plus 1, that is 11. Okay, then we have P3 completes its execution in 2 milliseconds, therefore it will be 13, 11 plus 2. So this is plus 10, this is plus 1, this is plus 2. Then we have P4, which completes its execution in 1 millisecond, so plus 1, that is 14. And finally we have P5, which completes its execution, and the burst time is 5 milliseconds, so this is 19, and here it's plus 5. Okay, so as you can see, the waiting time for P1 to get control over the CPU is 0 millisecond, that of P2 is 10 millisecond, as it has got the control at 10 millisecond. That of P3 is 11 millisecond. Then of P4 it is 13 millisecond. And of P5 it is 14 millisecond. Okay. So, from this we will calculate the average waiting time. So, the average waiting time is equal to 0 plus 10 plus 11 plus 13 plus 14 divided by number of processes, that is 5. Now this will come out to be 48 by 5, that is equal to 9.6 millisecond. Okay, so in this way you can calculate the average waiting time for FCFS algorithm. Okay, so if you like the video, please do hit the like button. And if you are new to this channel, please subscribe to my channel. Share the videos among your friends. Thank you.